Hi, this is Lynn from WisconsinGarden.net, soon to be WisconsinGarden.com, but that'll be a couple weeks from now. Today we are planting the final tomatoes of the season. I think we're done buying tomatoes now, and we've been waiting for weeks for this specific tomato plant to come in. It's called a tomato berry. We don't have any program with this company, whoever they are. It's just that we've used them now. This is our third year of planting them. And the thing that makes them so special is that they're very sweet. They stay on the vine when they get ripe and they do not split. And I'm planting them the same way that I have planted my other tomatoes. Nice deep hole. My special formula. And a pinch of sugar.
Now, you just posted your special formula on your last video.
I did.
So if anybody's interested in that, they can check it out.
It's a modification of Jerry Baker's planting formula. And it's very easy, and it has most of the ingredients that you can find in your, probably already in your home. So I make it nice and deep. I make sure the stem is covered a little bit more than what you would normally plant a regular flower. It goes in deeper, gives it a better stability. And then I always put the marker right here so I know what I'm doing. Then I will put my, sorry, Fuzzy, our little helper in the background here. Then I will sprinkle dry milk around the base, and that is to keep the fungus out and to add calcium. And every couple of weeks you just sprinkle a little bit more on. And then I will water it. And in between I'm going to be putting some grass clippings just to be mulching the areas that are not planted with another vegetable. Although there will be some marigold flowers and some sweet alyssum in here. Marigolds to keep the pests away, alyssum to attract the good bees. And then, this year I've also had some diatomaceous earth that I've been sprinkling around, just a little bit around the base. This is for pests that might try to crawl up and take a bite out of my plants, and I don't want them to do that. So that's something, if you're interested, that too, we did a video on diatomaceous earth.
Well, again, as a recap, one of the things you liked about this particular strawberry was that they didn't fall off the vine, right?
Yes. Mm-hmm. And you may notice I have my new hat on today. And that's because I'm protecting myself from the sun this year due to a problem that I had, a melanoma they found and I had removed, but I'm now protecting myself. I've got my sunscreen on, and so hopefully I'm protected.
And you got your dog to protect you too.
And I've got my mighty dog here to keep away the wolves and the raccoons. Ah.
So what else are you planning? What else are you planting today besides tomatoes? What's on your agenda?
I still have my green peppers that I'm planting, and I have some more kale that I'm planting, and I may be moving some of my broccoli to its home now. We started it earlier in the season under our hoop house, and now I want to move that to a more permanent location. And I also have seeds to plant. I have my butternut squash to plant, and perhaps some more carrots and some more cucumbers. So it's, and then all of the flowers that are going to have to go in here, my protecting flowers. So we're going to be busy today. Got to get back to work. Well, I'm just finishing up now. Here I'm putting in my marigolds and my sweet alyssum. Alyssum to attract the bees so they pollinate the flowers and we get tomatoes. And marigolds to keep away the harmful insects and maybe even some rabbits and deer that don't like the pungent smell. And I alternate. On that side I did a marigold, so this side I'm doing an alyssum in the opposite hole.
So your plants are syncopated?
And I'm putting a little moat around each one, so at least during these first waterings, the water will stay where you want them.
By the way, I wanted to thank one of our viewers who thought our earth masseuse comment was rather unique.
You are clever, Richard.
Well, Lynn is the earth masseuse. I just do the videoing.
And if you're lucky, sometimes you get multiples in the same little packet. This one has three in it, so I definitely will split them up and make use of all of them. Now the last step is putting the mulch on the ground where around your tomato plants. And that's what I use grass clipping for. These are grass clippings that have not been treated with chemicals, and you don't want to put them on real thick because that'll prevent the water from going in. But you need a nice, about an inch or two to start with, and you can always add more. And you want to keep it away from where your plant is. And this just keeps the moisture in and the weeds out. I hardly ever have to weed. And as this composts into the ground, then you add some more fresh clippings. Well, we're still planting. We haven't finished. We finished with the tomatoes, but now we're still working on the peppers in this lower garden. We bought some different cages because we've never had peppers here and we're afraid perhaps the deer and the rabbits will like to eat our peppers. So we bought some new cages and we've wrapped deer netting around them just like we do for our tomatoes. And then I'm also protecting my peppers against cutworms, which like to come and just cut your peppers right off. So I take a paper tube, cut them to the size, wrap them around, put a little tape on them or a spot of glue, and put it around as a collar. I'm also safeguarding with my diatomaceous earth also, just as a safeguard. And then put the cage over the top. Arrange it so no little sneaky rabbit can get underneath. And there you have it. Hopefully.
And how many more do you have to go?
I have 1, 2, 3, 4, I think 5 more. We could have had this garden done long ago if we didn't have to make cages to protect it from the rabbits and the deer. But then, they're God's creatures too, I guess.
You guess?
They are. So that's it for now. Thanks for visiting. Bye now.